Meet the Expert, a knowledge-sharing initiative of your knowledge partner, the Developing Bangladesh. We discuss on trade, investment, commerce, education, skills, economic development, global peace and prosperity, etc. issues. If you are interested to these issues, please subscribe to the channel. Developing Bangladesh, your knowledge partner, please subscribe now.
Web3 and AI, of course. For me, it's two technologies, but I'll be focusing on one today. I'm writing my own predictions for the next 10 years. I will publish it soon. It will be 10 technology predictions where I see that they have a future, and we're talking about AI and blockchain in specific is one of them. Why blockchain is very important and Web3 is very important? Because we are in a very early stage, and I love to preach about that because we are in a very early stage. Many ask me, are we in an early stage? I tell them yes, and my answer is yes, and why? Why are we in an early stage? We're currently the early adopters of this technology. Some of you say, did we miss the bus? No, my dears. Investment is something else, but as far as technology, no, we didn't miss the bus. There's a lot of investment in projects, a lot of ideas to develop. It's still brand new. We're still, you know, you want to replicate the whole banking system as part of something called decentralized finance, DeFi, versus centralized finance, CeFi. You want to replicate on a DeFi all of the instruments of traditional financial institutions, but empowered by cryptocurrencies, regardless of the price. As long as you do the deal, in the end of the day, you have to pay a certain price. Was it in something called stablecoin or another cryptocurrency which fluctuates? That's another thing. But the elements and the way and the business model is now being built on blockchain. User experience is a big pain currently in the Web3 space or the blockchain space, because we don't have really a full nice user experience, seamless, where you can, you know, do anything. You really, because the wallet, where you have to have a wallet, and the wallet access is kind of still not the best way you can do it. So that's why we want to see more projects. That's why we want to see more solutions for the problems being implemented. And we're still there. NFT was 4 years ago. It was more, but 4 years ago it started. But last year it took a hype. Again, to mention something which is key here. AI, artificial intelligence. If I'm going to ask a question, I know you cannot reply, but the idea is, do you know how old is AI? I'm going to pause for 2 seconds. Ask yourself, how old is AI? I'm going to answer you. It's in the 1950s, early 1950s. So we're talking about around 72 years. It took around 60 years for it to kind of mature, and it's still not fully mature. So imagine the blockchain and Web3 space, which is only 14 years old. So it took a lot of time for the AI to be where it is today. Of course, we didn't have the computing power then. We didn't have the technologies. Later on in the 80s and the 90s, with the creation of personal computers, it became more of a reality. And look now, what you needed to do maybe 12 years or 15 years ago that used to cost you millions of dollars, now you can rent a whole system on AWS, Amazon, and then do all of the calculation, the most biggest supercomputer under $1,000. So this brought us new, you know, if you are a university and then you want to, you know, create a new model and you want to test it and so on, that will take usually 1,000 years, where now you can do it under one day. That's a awesome, you know, advancements in our life. So the computation power is here. And now in Web3, we're talking about also the metaverse. What we see today in the metaverse is really the beginning, the small part of where we want to be. I sat down with Facebook engineers and I asked them that question. Where is the metaverse? Because, you know, Facebook has changed to Meta, right? So where is the metaverse going? They say they don't know. And they said that it will take them 10 years to see where the metaverse is going. My definition of the metaverse, it will be the next 3D model of communication. What do I mean with that? If you jump not long ago, 6 years back, okay, if you wanted to do a conference call like today you are doing, and you have somebody in the US, somebody in Bangladesh, somebody in India, somebody in Dubai, somebody in Australia, you know, we're 20 people trying to meet from different countries. You needed to install a lot of technologies to be able to do that conference call. And it will cost you maybe $300,000, $400,000 to do that one call. With advancements of technology, look at Zoom, look at Skype. They are giving us this technology for $0. You don't have to pay anything. If you want more features, you pay. But as a basic feature for us to be enabled to talk across the globe, $0. This is a big advancement, and this is the same way opportunities. Now, but what did we lose? Well, we lost the human factor. With those technologies, because it's a 2D technology, like now, we are talking in a 2D way. I talk, you might be able to answer, you might not be able to answer. We try to interact, but it's a flat experience. With a 3D model of communication, which is the metaverse, which is the next internet. I was watching today, by the way, a nice interview of Bill Gates in 1991, and they were talking about the internet. So he was describing that the internet is the next thing that will change lives. And today we are in the world of metaverse. It is the next best thing as the internet in 1990s, early 1990s, it is changing. So now the internet in that metaverse will be empowered by technologies. So I can put a goggle and then re-immerse with you as a 3D object, avatar representing me. And then later on, there'll be technology so I can sense, I can feel, I can smell, I can touch, I can interact, I can feel it in a better way. Will it be all immersive? In my opinion, not really, but we will be somehow having 20% of our lives spent in there. I don't think it will be fully. If you wanna watch a nice science fiction movie, Ready One Player, you can find it on YouTube, on Netflix, on many other platforms. It's a nice movie about the future of, you know, we didn't call it back then as a metaverse, but the future of a virtual world, if you want to know. So saying all of this brings me to something. What is that one thing I want to tell you? And I want you to take screenshots of this. We're jumping into the creator economy for Web3. We lived the creator economy in YouTube and Facebook and maybe TikTok, but it wasn't the right creator economy. We used to get a small percentage versus what the owners get. And we were always on the risk of being banned. You know, we could be making $10,000 a month using those technologies. It's a great amount, but we could make $100,000. But then maybe we wake up the next day and our account is banned for any reason. This is no longer the case. Going forward, there will be social medias. Look at Elon Musk, what he is doing now. He's trying to change Twitter, even though, you know, talking something, but walking the walk is something else. Walking the talk, I would say, is something else. He broke his promises yesterday and he banned another account where he previously was banned, and then he removed the ban, and then yesterday he banned it again. So in Web2, he can do that. But in a Web3 aspect, social media, you cannot do that. And this is where we want to be. And this is where the opportunities are. It's enabling the creation and trading of media, other digital assets. For the first time, now we can track music being played. For the first time, because it is written on the blockchain. Photos, we can now give power to the creator of the art itself on a blockchain. Royalties, we can give royalties if this art was sold as a digital content. The owner will have a royalty. This couldn't be possible in a 2D world, in our current world, I would say. So now we're looking for many companies in this business or have access to utilize here, especially merchandise, prediction in the market, business media, designs, and data, because data will be open so that you can monetize it in a way you can understand. If you look at this graph, just give me 1 second. And what do you see? I see business opportunities. I'm just trying to remove the bar in front of me. If we look at the metaverse, for example, okay, inside the metaverse, this virtual world, we need elements, right? We need team collaboration. We need learning and development. Education is a big part of the metaverse. Giving lectures, I attended my first university course 1 month ago with the University of Nicosia. And I invite you to register with the next course, open course for University of Nicosia. I'm not doing an advertisement, but they are there since 2015. They were the first university to give courses and master degrees on blockchain technologies and digital currencies. Last month, they released their first metaverse class. And the class is open and free for everybody to attend. They have three courses now, cryptocurrency, introduction to cryptocurrencies and blockchain, DeFi, introduction to DeFi, and there's a third course, the metaverse. They are now finalizing the first metaverse course, but if you follow them, you will understand and see that maybe January they will open. It's totally free. You can attend, learn, and if you want, you do the exam, you pay for your certificate, and you exit, and it's not a big amount. So they are giving you opportunities to interact with people, to see people. Every time there's 15,000 people attending globally. So imagine this is one of the possibilities or business opportunities they created for themselves. How can we add more as entrepreneurs? Recruitments, software for recruitments, partner experience, stakeholder engagement, shopping and marketplace. My vision for Amazon is in the metaverse. Today, how you shop on Amazon is great, but if you can, pinpoint more and then walk inside the metaverse, trying to see the product, holding the product, in a 3D aspect, turning the product, that will be an amazing experience during shopping. And this is what I mean living in the metaverse. You'll be jumping in, trying to buy your stuff, get your education, interact, talk to you or whatever, and then exit from it. Virtual real estate is a huge business in the world of the metaverse. Either building a metaverse and selling the real estate or real estate as real estate. We interviewed our part also, the founder of Sandbox. Okay, Sandbox is the number one metaverse currently. And Sebastian Bourguet is one of the amazing leaders. We interviewed him last week, and then it will be launched this Wednesday at 8:30 Dubai, at 8 actually Dubai time. So it will be in your time, I would say 12 midnight, if I'm not mistaken, or 1 a.m., but you can watch it later on. Do check it. It's an amazing interview.
Developing Bangladesh, your knowledge partner. We take care of trade and investment, education and skills, economic diplomacy and economic development. If you would like to keep you updated on these issues, please subscribe to Developing Bangladesh. Thank you very much for watching till the last.